Continuing our survey of early evolutionary thought, we now want to turn to the concept of Lamarckian evolution. This derives from this man, Jean-Baptiste de Lamarck, who lived from 1744 to 1829, who wrote a very important volume in 1809 called Philosophie Zoologique. Lamarck was the first scientist to recognize that species could change to entirely new forms. He then wrote, "Do we not therefore perceive that by the action of the laws of organization, nature has, in favorable times, places, and climates, multiplied her first germs of animality and increased and diversified their organs? Then, aided by much time and by a slow but constant diversity of circumstances, she has gradually brought about the state of things which we now observe. How grand is this consideration, and especially how remote is it from all that is generally thought on this subject?" So what he's saying here is that with enough time and enough sort of forces acting on a species, they can change. So they're barely recognizable descendants from their ancestors. And so if we look around, what we see on Earth today is the consequence of this incredibly long process of change. And he's saying that's different from the view of, say, Linnaeus, who thought that a divine creator had produced everything all at once. Instead, he's got this long history of organic change. Now, the importance of Lamarck today is that he proposed a precise mechanism of evolutionary change. This had not been developed until Lamarck. He said that through use and disuse, structures change over an individual's lifetime. Parts of our bodies will grow or shrink according to how much we use them. So we see this. Hey, here's the former governor of California, Arnold Schwarzenegger. And, you know, he did enhance this a bit with some steroids, but, you know, he pumped a lot of iron, okay? And we do know that if you pump iron, you'll build your muscles, okay? And so you have clear cases that certain parts of our body will indeed grow with more use. That's not controversial. Everybody would accept that. This is the part of Lamarckian theory that we can no longer accept. He said that these acquired characters are then passed on to descendants. So if we really work hard and grow our muscles, that our children should automatically therefore have more muscles. Well, this is the governor's children. This is his official family. This is his unofficial family with his former maid. But none of them are muscle bound, okay? They might well develop really big muscles as they grow up, but they're going to have to work for it themselves. They're going to have to do just as much exercise as he did back when he was an honest weightlifter. Besides the observation that weightlifters' children have to do just as much exercise to get decent bodies, we also know from cultural practices that there are really problems with Lamarck. For example, circumcision has been an important religious ritual in many societies for 1,000 years. And through use and disuse, we'd expect the foreskin pretty much to have eliminated from these groups of people already. So why is circumcision still necessary after thousands of years? More precisely, as a scientific exercise, a well-known German geneticist named August Weismann in the 1880s set out to test Lamarck's mechanism by chopping off the tails of lab rats generation after generation. Again, assuming that, well, they didn't use those tails, so therefore, eventually, the tails should disappear from the descendants. But nope, the tails did not disappear. The great-great-great-great-great-grandchildren of the rats who'd had their tails chopped off generation after generation still grew tails. But even more important is kind of a philosophical issue. I mean, would you really want to have a mechanism of evolutionary change that allowed the inheritance of acquired characters? Because most of the things that happen to us are pretty nasty. I mean, yeah, sure, you can do some weightlifting and build up your muscles, but what happens when you break a bone or you get a scar? Would those be inherited as well? And we know they're not. So we do not accept Lamarckian's mechanism for evolutionary change.